السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله وكفى صلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أرسله الله تبارك وتعالى رحمة للعالمين، إماما للمتقين، وحجة علينا نحن الخلائق أجمعين، فأخرجنا به من ظلمات الكفر إلى نور الإيمان بالله رب العالمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، اتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، أعلم أن الكثير منا ينتظر الحديث واستكمال الحديث عن الأسرة في الإسلام وعن حق الزوج على زوجته، بما أن يعني السواد الأعظم من المسجد هم من الرجال الذين ينتظرون التعرف على حقوقهم. ولكن لا أستطيع أبدا أن أتحدث عن الزوج وعن حقوق الأزواج دون أن أتعرض للزوج الأفضل أبدا، صلى الله عليه وسلم، في شهر مولده. لا ينبغي ولا يليق أن يمر علينا شهر ربيع الأول دون أن نتحدث عنه صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأن نتذكر سويا سيرته العطرة، وأن يكون لنا وقفة سريعة ووضعة سريعة معه صلى الله عليه وسلم في هذا اللقاء الطيب المبارك. So my dear brothers and listening sisters, everybody is waiting for the rights of the man, the rights of the husband upon his wife. As we said last week, it's going to be the topic for this week. But I was looking today and thinking about the month that we are in, the lunar month that we are in, the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. Today is the 10th of Rabi' al-Awwal, the month in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the best husband ever, the best human being ever sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he was born. So it's not proper at all that we, yani, the month of Rabi' al-Awwal comes and leaves without, you know, for those who attend with us every Friday in the evening, we talk about him every week, we celebrate him sallallahu alaihi wasallam every Friday after Salat al-Isha when we have the Seerah class. But I know that not everybody is able to come, so it's not proper to, yani, to let the month of Rabi' al-Awwal go without talking about him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. حينما تتحدث عنه تذكر دائما هذه الآية أنه منا من الله تبارك وتعالى عليك إن كنت مؤمنا. هكذا قال الله سبحانه وتعالى. تذكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بأنه عطاء عظيم من الله تبارك وتعالى لك أنت أيها المؤمن، ليذكرك ويعلمك ويزكيك ويطهرك. قال الله تبارك وتعالى، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. The first thing ever that you should think about him صلى الله عليه وسلم is that he is a great ni'mah, bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you as a believer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the believers. قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا. It's different levels. Islam, everybody is Muslim. But when you talk about Iman, not everybody is a believer. That's why you have to make the dua day and night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you from the believers and make your iman always on a good status. That is the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make his heart steadfast on his ibadah, on worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First thing ever, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a great favor upon you, upon the believers, by sending a messenger from amongst themselves to do three things. ليعلمهم الذي ومن لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آيات. First thing, to recite upon them his ayat, Quran. ويزكيهم, to purify them. ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة, and to teach them the book and the wisdom. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي ليس لله طاعة إلا بطاعته. هكذا قال الله, من يطع الرسول فقد أطاع الله. Whoever, there is no طاعة. Don't think ever for some people who tries sometimes to differentiate and to put a barrier between the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Hold on and listen to the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, whoever obeys Allah, whoever obeys the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is really obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا استكمال للإيمان إلا بمحبته. You cannot perfect your iman that we're talking about right now until you show love to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we will explain how is the love to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لا يؤمن أحدكم. This is the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. في صحيح البخاري يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين. None of you will perfect his iman, his faith, until he loves me, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, more than he loves his father, his parent, his children, and everybody else. If there is a barrier between you, if you feel sometimes that your son is more beloved to you than the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's something wrong with you. If you feel sometimes that your parent stopping you from obeying him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you have to listen to them because you want to be dutiful to your parent while they're asking you not to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is something wrong with you. This is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. النِّعْمَةُ الْمُسْدَاءُ وَالرَّحْمَةُ الْمُهْدَاءُ يَقُولُ عَنْهُ أو هو صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول عن نفسه. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الذي أورده الإمام مسلم في صحيحه، يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم: أنا سيد ولد آدم وأول من تنشق عنه الأرض وأول شافع وأول مشفع صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the prophet that you need to remember all the time. This is the prophet who was born in this month, the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. When you go to the book of Sirahs, you will find, you know what, some scholars, they say that he was born in the second of Rabi' al-Awwal, some others in the 8th, the 9th, the 10th, the 12th, the 17th, the 22nd. Many opinions about it. But let's stop at Rabi' al-Awwal, the month of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But for sure, he passed away sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that day, the day of the 12th, which is going to be Sunday. He passed on that day, and he used to be asked about it. And I have a little reminder at the end of the khutbah about how should we, you know, react and celebrate and show him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we care, and what are other stuff that is not even from the sunnah, and people stick to them and they forget about the main sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said about himself, I'm the master of the children of Adam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him that. He had the khutbah, special, a separate khutbah about the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said it, أَنَا سَيِّدُ وَلَدِ آدَمُ. In a different way, وَلَا فَخْرٌ. It's not an act of pride, it is the reality that you have to understand. If you're taking somebody else as your hero, if you let your kids follow somebody else and they don't follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you're wrong, and they are wrong. And there is something wrong in bringing up your kids. He said that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ تَنْشَقْ عَنْهُ الْأَرْضِ, the first one on whom the grave will be split, and the first one will intercede, and the first one will get his intercession accepted. وَأَوَّلُ مُشَفَّعْ, شَافِعْ وَمُشَفَّعْ. And you know the long hadith about that. All prophets, everybody's going to be talking about his own situation. I have no, I don't dare to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to intercede for humanity. And him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will come and he will say, أَلَا لَهَا, أَلَا لَهَا. I am the main intercessor, or interceder at that day, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. في يوم مولده حقوق كثيرة نغفل عنها لابد أن نتذكرها. في شهر مولده تذكروا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وتذكروا حقوقه عليكم. يا أخي حسان بن ثابت شاعر الإسلام يقول: وأفضل منك لم تر قط عيني وأحسن منك لم تلد النساء, خلقت مبرأا من كل عيب كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء صلى الله عليه وسلم. Think of him this way, the best of human being ever صلى الله عليه وسلم. And when you think about him this way and take that month as advantage, message for you to remember him, not only that you listen to something nice about the praising the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not only that you talk to a friend about him, not only that, you know what, you remember, oh mashallah, and you show yani that you are getting the influence of remembering the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not this. It's when you think about the rights of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam upon you on every single second of your life. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم له عليك حقوق له عليك حقوق لابد أن توفى منها. أولا كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى وقل أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول. Don't ever say I care and I remember him and you don't follow him and you don't obey him. And when we say obeying the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that, say to them, Ya Muhammad, obey Allah and obey the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولذلك الفضيل, يعني this statement will explain the obedience to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the first right of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم upon us. As I said in Arabic, maybe I missed the translation. يعني when you remember the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the month of Rabi al-Awwal, always remember the rights of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم upon you. And there are lots. We will touch some of them today. The first one ever is to obey him صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني many times, you know, you come, is it sunnah or fard? Many people, they come to you, you know what, is it sunnah or fard? Is there any disagreement or differences of opinions about it or not? You know what? It came in a hadith. It's not an ayah from the Quran that I follow this or I do this or I pray those rak'at before the salah or after the salah or I follow the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you. Clearly, you have to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you have to obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad said, يقول Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad رحمه الله, إن العمل إذا كان خالصا أو إذا لم يكن خالصا ولم يكن صوابا لم يقبل وإذا كان صوابا ولم يكن خالصا لم يقبل والصواب ما كان على السنة والخالص ما كان لله. Listen and contemplate and ponder upon the meaning of this important statement. If you're coming today just to show your friend that I'm praying like you, you're ruining your amal. If you come to the masjid every single day to show off and to tell the people that I'm a person who prays and this is not in your heart, there is something wrong with you. If you're really doing something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while it's not or it is against the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you're starting something, you know what, no, I'm doing it for Allah, and you're not doing it again according to the way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed to us, both of them are not acceptable. Again, Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad said, your actions or your deeds, if your deeds are not right but they are sincere, if your deeds are sincere for the sake of Allah, but they are not sound, they are not acceptable. And if your deeds are sound, but they are not sincerely for the sake of Allah, they are not acceptable. And he defined the sound is the one that is actually according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the sincere act, it is only for the sake of Allah. So you have to have both. You're doing your action, following and obeying the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you do them only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the rights and the main rights of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam upon you. And if I ask this question right now, the answer for sure will be absolutely. Do you love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Absolutely. I love him. What are you talking about, Sheikh? هل تحب النبي؟ أحد أهم الحقوق للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عليك كما قلت منذ قليل في الحديث أن تحبه. وإن سألنا السؤال الإجابة معروفة، أحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. عما تتحدث يا شيخنا؟ إني أحب النبي، وأنا أثق في هذه الإجابة. من منا يكره النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ كلنا يحب النبي. ولكن الله تبارك وتعالى حينما تحدث عن حب النبي ربطه بالاتباع والطاعة، ليس حبا باللسان وفقط، وإنما حبا بالعمل، بالتطبيق، بالاتباع. الله سبحانه وتعالى when he talks about loving the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he connected to following the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. If you really love Allah سبحانه وتعالى, if you really love Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you follow him صلى الله عليه وسلم. If you love the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, you follow him. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه. طب how come? To be honest with you, يعني بالله يعني كيف تحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنت دائما وأبدا تخالف سنته؟ يعني هو جه صراحة كده قال لك، وخلوني أكون يعني straight شوية لأن الكلام ما زال الأسئلة تأتي وكأننا يعني ندور في الدائرة مغلقة عن الربا. كل الأسئلة والقروض والأسئلة وبتيجي وهي كلها لعبة. It's all about يعني when you think about loving the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and you follow him صلى الله عليه وسلم, put yourself with one of his forbid or things that he forbid on you, and you see if you're able to abstain because you love him or you can't. You cannot resist the community. I cannot resist the needs. I need to have a nice house. I can't buy cash, so I will go and I will get mortgage. يا أخي, you know, other shiyukh, they said it's okay, and you know what? I don't care about other shiyukh. With due respect to everybody, all of our scholars, we admire them, we love them, we follow them, and we listen to them. But when it comes to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, telling you clearly this is haram, and you go against it, there's something wrong with loving him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's not that you, I wanna do it, but it's hard. No. If you find it hard, you don't love him. He said it clearly, and I'm taking just one example. Maybe I use it a lot because of the questions. Still, yaqi, you know what? There is a loan here. It's only 1% for the cards, for example. 1%, yaqi, 1%. 1% of 1%, it's a riba. It's interest. It's haram. He said that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ أَكْلَ الرِّبَى وَمُكِلَهُ وَكَاتِبَهُ وَشَاهِدَيْهُ. He said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curses four people. Four people when it comes to riba. The one who take, the one who give, the one who write, the two witnesses. Done. You want to be there, up to you. You want to witness, up to you. Somebody was posting a question. He wants to know who is really the witness on riba. Where in the transaction? Yahi, anybody. If you go with your friend, and you are approving that, you are one of the witnesses. It doesn't have to be somebody writing his name, because some people they say, you know what, I don't write my name. But you're leaving him, you're taking him to the agency, you're taking him to the bank, you do this, you do this. If you don't say I love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, then you have to stop and talk to yourself. Do you really love him? Yes, wallahi I love him. Khalas, sit with yourself and listen and reconsider your ibadah. It's not, the birth of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's not about gathering and having halaqat and having some food. And you know what, remember, there is a nice story about him صلى الله عليه وسلم. Speaking of a husband, for example, and this is something that I tried to start with, but I forgot it. Now I got it back. Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, when we talk about a husband, اسأل السيدة عائشة كيف كان حينما تتحدث عنه كزوج. هذا هو النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي يجب علينا أن نقتدي به.
سئلت سيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها فقيل لها ما كان يصنع النبي في بيته؟ يا أخي اسمع، يا أخي عقل، يا أخي اتبع، يا أخي لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. الله سبحانه وتعالى sent them to you for you to follow, not for you to ignore, not for you just to read and to forget. سيدة عائشة was asked one day how he or how was the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم inside the house. Oh, very tough, very bad. Everything is wrong. Complaining about everything. I don't like this and I don't like that. Don't do this, don't do that. Kids are scared when the father at home. Wife are so worried all the time. Don't pick up the phone. Do this, don't do that. He never used to be like that. He was as she described him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان في مهنة أهله فإذا نوري الصلاة خرج الصلاة. So as long as it's not the prior time, he used to be in service, always in serving his family, in the service of his family. And she used the word مهنتي أهلي, serving his family, with the general meaning of serving. You have a server at home, he's doing everything for you. وَلِلَّهِ وَلَرَسُولِهِ وَلَرَسُولِهِ دَائِمًا الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. أخي, you love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, you follow him. You love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and you remember him in that great month, the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. You recall how he used to deal, you recall his orders, you recall the things that he forbade us, and you stop with yourself and you follow him. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. أدعو الله تبارك وتعالى وأنتم موقنون. الحمد لله وكفى, وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وبعد, من حقوق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد أن تظهر طاعته عمليا وتطبيقيا وأن تظهر محبته عمليا وتطبيقيا, أن يعني كما دائما يعني أتذكر هذا القول الرائع لسيدنا سعد بن أبي وقاص حينما قال كنا نعلم أو نربي أبناءنا مغازي رسول الله كما نعلمهم السورة من القرآن. أن يكون لك علاقة دائمة ومستمرة معه صلى الله عليه وسلم, أن تتعلم عنه, أن تعلم غيرك عنه, أن تقرأ عنه. هذا هو يعني مفهوم لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. This is how to take the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم as an example to follow, is to know about him, is to read about him, is to read about his life, his biography. One of the rights of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم upon you that you know about him. Knowing about him will make it easy for you to follow him. But if you don't know, you're not following. And you can't follow, and you can't claim that you're following him if you don't know. Every single little thing, you need to ask about it. Right, to ask is a great thing, but you have to learn. And I said it before, yani even in the same context in which we're talking about the rights and duties of the husband towards his wife, that you teach her. But what about if you don't know? And هذا الحق الثالث يقودنا إلى حق رابع يشملهم جميعا. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حينما تجد إنسانا يعني يتعرض لسنته أو يتعرض لشخصه, كيف تدافع عنه وأنت لا تعلم عنه شيئا؟ So the rights, or one of the rights, and that's the fourth one that we have for today, is after learning about him, after reading his sirah, it will take you to a very important thing, one of the rights upon you, that you defend him صلى الله عليه وسلم. And defending him, it doesn't mean that you go to a non-Muslim and somebody is as we had like few years ago, somebody is writing or mentioning something bad about him. I don't care about those people, to be honest with you. What really scares me is us Muslims. When some Muslims, they come to you and say, you know what, I don't like this hadith. It doesn't make sense to me. That's actually insulting the Prophet ﷺ. If the hadith is authentic and it's mentioned in one of the authentic hadith books, who are you to say that? But if I'm not able myself as another Muslim to explain it to you, to be able to defend the Prophet ﷺ, then we both in a problem. So we have to defend him ﷺ based on the information and the knowledge that you have. طيب يا شيخ انت بتتكلم النهارده علمني يعني لخص الموضوع دعوني ألخص الخطبه في عجاله في دقيقتين ان شاء الله تعالى تحدث عن المولد وعن مولد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وعن هذا الشهر ويعني طب ماذا يجب علينا ان نفعل يعني كيف نحتفل نحن المسلمين بمولد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني how should we, if you're talking about this and you talk about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and this is the month of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني what should we do to celebrate the birth of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Some people, by the way, on my way to the masjid, they saw, they thought that I'm Santa. So the because of the uniform, so I'm celebrating the Christmas. We're not doing this anyway and we're not celebrating anything. And if you want to really, if you want to celebrate the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, listen to him. هو النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في حديث يعني سئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن صيامه يوم الاثنين. اليوم الذي ولد فيه سئل لماذا يصوم يوم الاثنين فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم هو يوم ولدت فيه. يعني احتفال النبي طبعا في حديث آخر بيوضح لماذا الصيام في حد ذاته في الاثنين والخميس وليس هذا الخميس وهذا ليس موضوعنا ولكن احتفال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يحتفل بمولده كل يوم اثنين بأن يصوم تقربا لله تبارك وتعالى. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked about fasting the day of Monday in which he was born. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم that's the day in which I was born and I do that, I fast to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إذن the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do ibadah to celebrate that day, not on an annual basis, not on a monthly basis, not on every other year. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to celebrate it every single week by fasting that day, يعني for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, يعني أنا as I said at the beginning of the khutbah, it's not even confirmed that this is the 12 differences of opinion about it. I don't think that we should do anything. But, however, and I read about it a little bit this morning, however, there is no harm that يعني the month of Ramadan remind us with يعني great things. And we talk about many things in Ramadan. And the month of Dhul Hijjah reminds us with the Hajj. It gets you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you remember things of ibadah. And it encourages you to do more. I don't see any harm in a person like taking advantage of this month and the memory and the birth of the Prophet ﷺ and read about him ﷺ. Get his family, you know what, and start a halaqa with his family. You know what, let's start. You start not to allocate that month for this or that day for this. You start something. Make it a start for a good thing for you and your friends and your family. يعني to remember the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and to take advantage of this month inshallah ta'ala based on the opinions of scholars there's no harm with this however to come on the day itself and celebrate to celebrate and to have halaqas and to have food and يعني as if we know the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم only on that day I don't think that this is any act of sunnah and this is not something that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked you to do and it applies by the way and might be some people will be shocked with this it applies to your own birthday why you do it aslan yeah? for what and for which you do a birthday for yourself or for your kids why يعني it's an act of يعني I'm not gonna say bid'ah but it's not something from the religion that we should do or we should follow or we should initiate so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is with you has to be with you every single moment of your life but no harm to take advantage of the month, of the memory, of the day of the birth of the Prophet ﷺ, the month of the birth of the Prophet ﷺ, and you start. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from those who listen him, Allah and his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, listen to both of them and they follow both of them. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلنا جميعا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه كما نسأله سبحانه وتعالى في هذا الشهر العظيم المبارك شهر ربيع الأول الذي ولد فيه صلى الله عليه وسلم ومات فيه صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يجعلنا جميعا من الذين يتبعون سنته. اللهم اجعلنا من المتبعين لسنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اجعلنا من المتبعين لسنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، كفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين.